Hey, good morning, my friends. Still morning. I'm MLive Chief Meteorologist Mark Torregrossa with your MLive Morning Weather Update. A little late this morning. I wanted to see what the new information, the new model runs looked like, and more importantly, what the experts from the Storm Prediction Center are saying. And so we're going to get right into it. And basically, the change from earlier this morning when I wrote a post was that the chance of large hail in the southeast part of Michigan has increased. And the most important thing I can show you is the satellite picture and the bright sunshine in the southeast right now. And that will fuel the storms this afternoon that are already starting to develop. All right, so here's the current radar. And there have been thunderstorms up in northwest lower from Gaylor down through Frankfort, through Traverse City, down rolling through Cadillac. Now and in the last half hour, and then down toward Muskegon. That line is probably going to continue to move to the east and remain marginally severe. The next line will develop as we get into the early afternoon. So here is, and by the way, if you could, this is the way we update you on severe weather here on MLive. If this is the first time for you joining us, make sure you like the MLive Facebook page and allow notifications. And go to the MLive Facebook page a couple of times for a couple of days, and then you'll get the notifications. If you don't go for a few days, then Facebook will think you don't care, and they'll stop the notifications. All right, so here is the late morning update on severe weather from the Storm Prediction Center. They're the experts. I would give them a really good shout out as being knowing what they're talking about. So this is the overall severe weather scenario, and that orangish tan area that you see in southeast lower Michigan, that's what we call an enhanced chance of severe weather. That's for this afternoon. And I'll give you the timing here in just a moment. This is MLive Chief Meteorologist Mark Torregrossa. If you could hit the share button, that would be tremendous. So we call it five levels, all right? The lightest green is just general thunderstorms, not severe. Then the northwest part of the state down toward Grand Rapids in level one. Then level two is the yellow. Then level three out of five is the enhanced level. Now, as far as tornadoes go, there is the possibility of a couple of isolated tornadoes. It's not really a tornadic situation, but it could produce one. So you want to be careful for that. 2%, a lot of people always give us heat. Wow, 2%, big deal. That is a significantly increased chance of a tornado in any one spot over what we normally have on any given day. But the wind, and more importantly, the hail, will be the greatest threat. So this is the chance of a damaging wind gust of 58 miles an hour or more within 25 miles of a point. The southeast, part of the thumb through Oakland County, Ann Arbor. I'm going to be detailing this, by the way, in a post on MLive and give you the exact cities, the exact zoomed in map. But just know now that as the storms gain steam into the southeast part of the state during the second half of the afternoon, that's where the highest chance of severe wind gusts are. And this is probably the most important one of them all. And the thing you should get out of this, and the thing you should get out of all of this from me, is put your car in the garage in southeast and southern Michigan if you can. Or if you go to work and you can go in a parking garage, parking ramp, or out at a surface lot, go into a parking ramp, because there's a chance, fairly significant chance, of large hail. Now, remember, oftentimes we get accused of crying wolf. Severe weather is inherently very isolated, even when widespread. So if you like to gamble, your chances of not getting hit by large hail are higher than getting hit, but the chance is quite high today. So what you see is the red shaded area has a 30% chance of 1 inch hail. Okay. Then the yellow shaded area, 15% chance, and the brown shaded area, 5% chance. But then you see kind of a black outlined area with these little black, we call it hatch marks, a little black diagonal lines. That area inside that black solid line has a 10% chance of 2-inch hail or larger. 2-inch hail does significant damage to a car. It can damage siding. It can damage a roof. So in other words, the storms this afternoon could be large hail producers. Now, I told you there's one, that's important data, but the one important weather map I can show you is the satellite picture. So remember on this afternoon, it's all contingent upon how much sunshine we have. If we have a lot of sunshine in the southeast, which we do now, then the temperature warms up, the instability builds, and the chances of hail go up. So look at the visible satellite right now, and you can see that it is clear. Saginaw, through Plum, through Flint, there are puffy clouds starting to build from Ann Arbor to Grand Rapids, Kalamazoo. Those puffy cumulus clouds, those show the instability building at the surface. So they do block the sun, but not a lot. You're still getting strong heating. And Rachel Bancroft, you've nailed it. She says, unfortunately, we have a ton of sun here in Fenton. Yes, that is definitely correct. So it's definitely one and done. And you can see the line of storms developing in the northwest part of the state. So the Storm Prediction Center came out with what we call a mesoscale discussion just recently, and it says storm coverage and intensity is expected to increase. So let me get it so you can see it. And they say that obviously a weather watch issuance is likely, probably a severe thunderstorm watch. But, you know, possibly a tornado watch. But again, the emphasis is more on large hail. Then the second emphasis would be severe winds along a squall line real fast. You know, you're talking 5 minutes of severe weather. GR about to get smacked? No, GR is right on the edge of this. So now this is the radar forecast. And I was going over this with my buddy Ted this morning. What this model has been doing for 6 months, I almost feel like the time is off on it. This model has been 1 hour too slow in forecasting. That is, if the model shows a thunderstorm at your location at 1 o'clock, it's generally been arriving at noon. Yeah. So when we see the thunderstorms clearing southeast Michigan at 6, it probably means they clear them at 5. So we're close, but don't pin it down just to the minute. He was watching a TV weathercast. He said, yeah, they said in Traverse City we'd be coming through at noon, and it came through at 11. And then I told him, I said, yeah, I've been seeing this model 6 months or so, being off a little bit. So here we are at 3 o'clock. This afternoon, which in my theory, remember, is really 2 o'clock. So storms are developing around Saginaw, Bay City, Midland. Storms are developing in the southern part of the state around Lansing, Jackson. And don't take this as, oh, there's a storm there in Jackson, but not in Lansing. It's not that exact either. So you take the fact that it's coming in the second half of the afternoon. This is 4 o'clock, which we'll call 3 o'clock, Ann Arbor, Detroit, the Thumb. 4 o'clock, I'm adjusting for you, okay? P.D. Solomonson says, travel not recommended in western Benzie County, wires, trees per emergency services. Tony Crino, any chance of hail around the Kalamazoo area? You are in the hail chance, not the significant hail chance. That's more Ann Arbor, Jackson, all of the Detroit area, all of Oakland County, and the Thumb. So this is 4 o'clock this afternoon, and then 5 o'clock this afternoon, and then 6 o'clock this evening. So we're looking at really, you know, in the morning into early afternoon, the northern half of Lower Michigan could get in on the severe weather. Saginaw, Midland Bay City, maybe one, 2 o'clock or so. And then the heat of the day, 3 to 6, the southeast, it would swing on through. So it's really a pretty simple scenario to understand. It's a squall line. You take cover inside a sturdy building as it approaches. There can be a lot of lightning. If you have a good car, like I said, try to get it inside of a building if you're really concerned about it. Some people want to say, I'm going to move my cars outside. Well, then you got to argue with insurance. And I know how that goes, from our house being hit by a hurricane, our someday retirement home being hit by a hurricane in Florida. Insurance doesn't make it easy for you. So it's a lot easier to move your good car that you like inside. All right, so I've covered the severe weather. You've got the scenario. We watch for thunderstorms to build, a squall line to push through, especially in the southeast, 3 to 6. A large hail possible, damaging winds possible, isolated tornado possible. I will update it just like this live on Facebook. Let's go into the weekend then and into the future, as I normally do earlier in the morning. And so we have a dry Friday. We have a nice Friday, cooler. Should be a dry Saturday. Sunday, everything kind of indicates that in the afternoon, we may have some scattered thunderstorms develop. Christmas timeline for when it will hit Bad Axe. I would say Bad Axe is between 1 and 3 in the afternoon. Here's Monday. Here's Tuesday. You don't see it, but the heat is starting to build. The southwest's coming back. Linda Sue Herlin, any chance of severe thunderstorms in the Bay City area? Yes, lesser chance than in the southeast part of the state, but 1, 2 o'clock maybe in the Bay City area. Next Thursday, next Friday. Notice, now this is far out, but notice thunderstorms heading straight south on this. What will we get into next week? We will get into a lot of different ways that us meteorologists call it. We get into the ring of fire, which means there's a hot dome just to our south and storms right up along that. I call it ridge runners. The storms run across the top of that ridge down into Michigan. So what is that? That's also the derecho setup. Not that I'm saying we will have one just yet next week or in the next couple of weeks, but the overall upper air pattern looks set up for that. So we'll keep an eye on that. And at times we will get into the hot weather. Then at times the storms will knock it down. So today we make it to the mid to upper 80s in that sunshine in the far southeast. That's what fuels the thunderstorms. Can you recap thunderstorms for Saginaw, please? Teresa Stefanski. Saginaw, you're probably between noon and 2 o'clock. And yes, you're in the severe weather chance. Maybe a storm that produces 1-inch hail. But I really feel like the threat is in that southeast third. Mountain Calm area, Thomas Molka, Vesterberg area. You're probably almost through it because the storms are trying to move through there now. Tomorrow, gorgeous. 75 in the north, low 80s in the south, lower humidity. Saturday, nice. 78 to 82. Sunday, low 80s. Monday, starting to get back to the mid 80s. Brownstown, Cynthia Stoutenberg. You're going to have to remind me where Brownstown is. New Baltimore area, right in the heat of it, Diane Alexander, and that's a 3 to 6 in the afternoon thing. You've got the Highest temperature, so you have to watch out the most. Tiffany Joseph, Grand Rapids, that's a good point. The line of storms is probably going to push through you in the next 2 hours and probably not be severe. William Ford, your steak fry in Birch Run could have a thunderstorm at 4-ish, and then once it clears, it clears. So this next Wednesday, 90, and then next Thursday, maybe around 90, and then next Friday in the 90s, Saturday in the 90s. We don't know exactly what the temperatures will be doing next week. It just depends on how close the edge of the heat gets, but it's certainly going to be upper 80s, maybe low 90s, maybe mid 90s if you get a sunny day and the storms lay off. So in one more point, it's a squall line that moves through. You probably get a half hour of very stormy weather wherever it occurs, and then it tapers off for 15 minutes, and then it's done, and we almost go back to sunshine. So let's get some other. We still got 370 folks, and they're asking. So I'm going to adjust the time for you, so you don't have to worry about that. Okay. Let me see if I got a later run here coming in. Okay, we don't. This is the latest. That's why we like the high-resolution rapid refresh, because it comes in every hour. So let's go to 2 o'clock. So people asking about Grand Rapids. It looks like the weather could skip over Grand Rapids. The storms are starting to extend to the south and west. But it's going to be through you in the next hour or so, and the steam will really build as it moves toward the east. Brighton, please. Emily Lilinski, you're going to be in the heart of it. This is 4 o'clock. I'm sorry, this is 3 o'clock. No, Becky Showers, I don't want to pick on you. But remember, she comments, and of course it splits around Lansing. Remember, the models are good, but don't take this cell here, I'll get nothing. Sometimes it works out like that, but not often. So this could be a solid line, and the next run we might see the line be forecast to look a little more solid, and then so on and so on. Let's see. Hail, Michigan, out in the thumb. You're looking at it 2 to 4. Milan, please. We have an outdoor event 5 to 8 and a barge. Remember, 1 hour of severe storms, then drying out. Milan's probably at the 5 o'clock hour, so you might have a 5 to 6, and then you might dry out, or it might have just blown past you. Becky Showers, no problem. Hey, like your last name, Showers. Dogs are terrified of thunder. That was one of the best things about Bagel, our beagle, who is still around, 19 now. Vet says he's 95 years old. He's deaf, so he no longer gets paranoid about the thunder, because he doesn't hear it. Once in a while, he feels it. Lewiston, you're going to be in the thunder and lightning here very shortly, and you might have low-end severe thunderstorms. Let me see if I can get the radar scope up for you. Okay, hold on just a second here. I guess I don't have it running. Okay. Just a moment. Bear with me a second. Okay, here's the radar, the current radar. So you can see the line starting to build. Now, that might be a tornado watch that was just issued. Let's go back and see. Bear with me a second. Severe thunderstorm warning issued for Osceola County. They're thinking that maybe a house is on fire in the Frankfurt area from a lot of lightning earlier. James Day, Jim Brielt, good morning. How you doing? Gladwin, you're going to be in it here very shortly. Potent thunderstorm, and then it'll be on to the east. Ambrose Washer used to call me at the news station when she was 12. Now she's 39. Uh-oh, I'm getting old. Sharon Bologa, Livonia, sunny skies and blue skies. Yes, wait for the rain. Mother Nature, that's one good side of this, is that when Mother Nature puts down a nice rain, it's a lot easier than you having to drag the hose all around. Marsha, did I say hail? Yes, I did. Let's go back and just give you a recap for those who are just joining us. Fremont only heavy rain, John Stack. Yes, thank you. And they are. So remember, we're watching the sunshine in the southeast. That will spark the storms. The Storm Prediction Center says that my computer's locked up, that the greatest chance of severe weather is in this enhanced area. Okay, there we go. We're catching up now. Oh, accidentally just closed out. Just give me a second here. We'll get a couple of updates from their severe weather outlook through the afternoon. Okay, here we go. So the 2% chance of a tornado stretches from, oh, let's call it Tawas to Mount Pleasant to Kalamazoo. That's probably not the main feature. The wind gusts gaining steam as they go into the Southern Thumb, the Detroit area, Ann Arbor, and Southeast. And then the main thing is that there's a possibility of large hail. Jackson, Don, Yenny, you're just on the edge of the large hail. I feel like it's going to be in the Southeast part of the state. And so there you have it. You're ready now. All you have to do is common sense. Wait it out an hour as it moves through. Remember, lightning your biggest threat. You don't want to be outside. Hail, get your good car in the garage or good cars. And I'll keep you updated. Simple as that. How's that? So there's your MLive weather update. Bookmark this page and go to the MLive Facebook page a couple of times. Some of you aren't newsies. You know, I understand that. Just go to a couple of stories if you can. And then Facebook will think that you want to be alerted when we go live on weather. And if you stop doing that for a couple of days, Facebook will think, oh, they don't care anymore. And you'll stop getting alerts. So that's the fix there. I'm MLive Chief Meteorologist Mark Torregrossa. Anna Brown, we didn't really answer that. What time for Detroit? You're looking at about 4 on the west side of Detroit to 5 or 6 on the east side of the Detroit. I'll keep you updated and watch for a post that shows a little closer, more distinct, where this severe weather could occur. I'm going to work on that right now. Thanks for joining me on the MLive Morning Weather Update. Bye.